Sure. Do what you need to do. Let me know when you're ready. When you're ready to go.
Yeah. How was your week been? Okay. Busy.
Yeah, it's been a good week. Last week, since I spoke to you guys, it's been quite busy. I've just been in the conference up until Sunday, and then last couple of days, getting a chance to unwind. So yeah, I've been easier, more available, I'll say.
Are you arriving in Vegas on the 10th or the 11th or the 12th or what?
The 12th. I'll be there on the 12th. Yeah, when do you arrive?
I got to be honest with you, I haven't actually booked my flight yet. I'm actually going to book it tomorrow or late tonight. there's plenty of spaces left right now. There's plenty of options.
Okay, great.
So I'm all booked in with my hotel and everything, you know?
Okay, is your hotel booked?
Yeah, the hotel is booked, yeah.
Okay, great, yeah, because that I know that was filling up quite fast, so as long as that's booked, that's important. And I think most of the guys are arriving on the 12th, so yeah, maybe perhaps just book your flight and work such a way that you get there on the 12th as well.
What business are you talking about, guys?
We haven't started yet. Prakash, is it?
Yes, but I'm saying what is on the 12th?
Oh, sorry, that's the event, the big event for Galaxy Mining, LifeStyle Galaxy.
Oh, Galaxy Mining, okay.
And also we're visiting Vegas for the two-day GoPro event with Tony Robbins and Eric Worre.
Oh, really?
That's the biggest event of the year, that is, yeah.
Excellent.
And then we're visiting a mining farm then in Washington State, Bitcoin mining farm. So yeah, it's all looking good.
So Prakash, you're welcome to join us in Vegas for the company event and the GoPro event with Eric Worre and Tony Robbins as well.
I would love to, but I think it's short notice for me now. It's 12. I would imagine the tickets are already gone.
Well, if you need tickets, we do. I think we might have tickets, some tickets available because we did pre-purchase a certain quantity of tickets. So if you do need a ticket, we might actually be able to get a ticket. Yeah.
I listen to him near enough every morning, Tony Robbins. It's my daily wake-up call.
Nice morning ritual.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah, Prakash, let me know if you want to come and let me change your mind. The guys who turn up are always the guys who make more money.
Tony Robbins, wow, that would be excellent. I would imagine there's an atmosphere. What can I ask how much it will cost for that ticket?
The ticket?
For the venue.
I'm trying to think of the ticket price right now, actually. Adrian, do you remember what the ticket price is? Is it $400?
Yeah, I think it's $400 for a basic ticket. And then the VIP ticket, I think it's about $900, the VIP.
Yeah. So Prakash, if you try and get one on the site at the moment, it's actually about $600 for a standard ticket. But because we did pre-purchase some tickets, we actually do have them available at about $400.
And that's for the three-day event, is it?
Yes, that's for the three-day event with Eric Worre, Tony Robbins, Pitbull, Brendan Burchard.
Oh, that would be so beautiful.
Yeah, if you want to come through, it's going to be a life-changing event and sometimes the most...
I will put it in there and if I can, I will get in touch with you.
Great. Sometimes the best things happen spontaneously. So yeah, just go with it.
That's the story of my life. I always, things like that happen with me. Unplanned things, yes.
Yeah, that's the way. Great stuff. Okay, just going to kick this off then. Welcome to everyone for the call. This was supposed to have been a call last night, but it was Halloween night last night. I had to go to a private party, so we couldn't do the call last night at the same time, 8 o'clock. So it's going to be every Tuesday, 8 o'clock. That's the plan, UK time. But we're doing it on a Wednesday. There's a bit of a one-off this week. So I'm just going to, everybody on the call knows myself. For those of you who don't, my name is Adrian Hibbert, and I'm based in Cardiff in South Wales in the UK. And I'm a property expert for the last sort of 20 years, more or less, since I left school. But I've been specializing in sort of Bitcoin, cryptocurrency, altcoins, and all that sort of blockchain technology for the last probably 2.5 years now. And my income has basically gone through the roof in the last couple of, in the last year and a half. I've hit around $4.5 million now in Bitcoin and altcoin cryptocurrency. For those of you who've been watching my Facebook page, you'll see that's all for real. I haven't actually cashed out. I haven't actually cashed out yet into real dollars. Well, I call it dollars really, not real to a certain degree. I am actually cashed out and sort of enhanced my lifestyle as I get, but I'm just staying in. This is a 3-year plan for me. So I'm just accumulating as much Bitcoin cryptocurrency as I can over the next couple of years. And then at some point, I'll probably decide what to do with it all, but I haven't yet. But anyway, I'm going to introduce you to a guy now called Nilesh. He's going to do a presentation on a new project opportunity that I've taken on. I got involved with it actually last December, January, but didn't take any action. So in the last sort of 4 or 5 weeks, I've bought into this new project, this Bitcoin mining project, which I'm really excited about. And I'm building this now, obviously well into 2018. And I think this is going to be one of the biggest out there as we speak. So over to you, Nilesh. And yeah, if you can do a presentation for us, that'd be great for all the new people. Try and keep it, as short and sweet as you can. And because last time, guys, if you were on, this went on into the midnight. We're 12:30 midnight last week. So I want to try and keep it to less than 2 hours if we can, or, you know, sort of a 45 minute sort of presentation. If we can, a bit less, and then questions and answers on the actual opportunity after that. So over to you, Nilesh, introduce yourself and where you're from and what you've been up to the last couple of years and why you got involved with this this incredible Bitcoin opportunity.
Hi, Adrian. Thanks for that. And hi to everyone watching this out there. My name is Nilesh Harbhajan. I'm from South Africa. And we're going to be speaking about a company called LifeStyle Galaxy this evening in the UK. And just to tell you a little bit about myself is that, as I said, I'm from South Africa. Right now, I'm currently in California in the United States. I'm not based here. However, I am up here for certain things that I need to do. But I am based in South Africa, originally from South Africa. My background is accounting and auditing, which, I have been working in the corporate world with that. And I, like Adrian, got involved with the Bitcoin and cryptocurrency industry just over approximately 2.5 years ago. And to say that it changed my life would be an understatement. It has, you know, just opened up so many new doors and new opportunities and given me new avenues. And it has changed my life. And what are we going to speak about this during this time we have together? Is a company called LifeStyle Galaxy, which is the company for me that I choose to do Bitcoin mining with. And I'm going to get into more detail about exactly what Bitcoin and Bitcoin mining is about. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to share my screen and just let me know when you are able to see it.
Yeah, okay. I'm gonna mute everyone now, okay? So only Nilesh is speaking, okay?
Okay, great. So
just bear with me, Nilesh, while I mute everyone. Just bear with me 2 seconds.
Sure, just let me know when that's done, Adrian. Yeah.
Okay, fire away, Nilesh. You're unmuted. Great stuff.
Okay, great. Thanks, Adrian. Okay, so we're going to be speaking about Bitcoin mining and a company called LifeStyle Galaxy here during the time that we have together. As I said earlier, my name is Nilesh Harbhajan, all the way from South Africa, and let's dive straight into it. So during the time that we have together, we're going to be discussing three things. We're going to be discussing exactly what is Bitcoin that is taking over the world right now, getting so much attention. Why should you get Bitcoin? And how do you profit from Bitcoin? Because even though there's a lot of people out there in the world right now who know what Bitcoin is, they still have no idea how to make money from it. And if you're watching this right now, we're going to show you how you can profit with Bitcoin and exactly what Bitcoin is about. So let's go back to about 6,000 years ago. How did value get traded in the marketplace? Well, 6,000 years ago, this thing called money wasn't around. And what would happen is that if you needed a new suit and you own some cattle, what you would do is that you would trade your cattle or part of your cattle for a new suit, or you would trade it for, you know, food or whatever it is that you would need. So 6,000 years ago, people would use trading as a way of exchanging value for value. But what actually happened is that during time and during the evolution of mankind, about 3,000 years ago, coins were introduced. Because what happens if you need like one suit and that's only worth the leg of your goat that you need to pay for it for? So why, you know, cut off the leg of the goat and have the goat lying there when you only need one suit? So what happened is that coins were introduced 3,000 years ago. And coins is just another means that we would use, or people used back in the day, to trade value for value. But as time went along and the Robin Hoods of the world came along in forests, it became a bit more dangerous to be carrying coins, as well as coins were getting a bit heavy to carry around. So what happened is that in the 17th century, the world had an epiphany at that time, and they decided to introduce bank notes. Now, I want you to go back into the 17th century and think how this was. Now, here you've got people or governments telling you, hey, we're going to take this thing called paper, we're going to put a value on it, and instead of using the coins and instead of using bartering, we are going to now give you this piece of paper, and it's going to be worth $50 or $100, whatever the value may be. But when we look at it today, that's all that we know, because we're so used to paper money. But even with paper money, money evolved again, because as the world grows, we need new ways of exchanging value for value. So in the 1950s, the first credit card was introduced. And I want you to go back in time again. So think about this. If you were around in the 1950s, or maybe you were a kid in the 1950s, or you have access to someone who was around in the 1950s, think about the mind shift that happened for them. Here they are with this plastic card saying, hey, you don't need to use notes anymore, but all you need to do is swipe this card, which has a magnetic strip on it, and it's going to record the transaction. Needless to say, when during the 1950s, people were like, this thing isn't going to work. However, what happens now if you try to book a flight without a credit card? Try booking hotel accommodation. What about getting an Uber? You can't do most things in the world today without a credit card. But yet in the 1950s, it was seen as a new bold step that wouldn't be adopted. And as time has gone on and as the world has evolved, and the world is not getting any bigger, the world is actually getting smaller with cell phones, with the internet, with laptops and iPads, tablets, all of these things, the world has become smaller. And everything that we do is based on technology. So money has changed again. And now we've now moved to what's called digital currency. And that led to January 2009, the first Bitcoin being mined. Now, if you at this stage saying, hey, what is a Bitcoin? Okay, we're going to get to that. So don't worry if you don't understand at this point in time exactly what a Bitcoin is. We're going to get to that. Just know right now that Bitcoin is a digital currency that was introduced because the world is actually becoming smaller with the use of the internet, and it's evolved in such a way that we need a change in the way that we are doing money. So in 2009, money changed again, just as it changed from bartering to coins, to paper money, to plastic credit cards. It's now changed to digital currency. And in 2009, we produced the first Bitcoin. So Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency and it is referred to as digital gold. Why do we call it digital gold? It's called digital gold because it is limited in supply. Unlike paper money, which governments at this point in time are printing as they see they need more money. But what actually happens is that as they print more money, it is leading to inflation, which is why we actually find that even though people might have more money than 50 years ago, they might be able to buy less things. So Bitcoin is a limited supply and it has a value that's determined by market forces of demand and supply. So it's very much like coastal property and gold. Why do we say that? Because right now, Bitcoin is finite. Just like gold, if you need more gold from the ground, it's not so easy to go back to go and just start digging gold from the ground and get it. However, go back 200-300 years ago, it was a lot easier comparative to now to get gold from the ground. Same story with coastal property. If you could go back about 200-300 years ago and you could get coastal property that you knew would be developed along the way, or even 50 years ago, if you could get your hands on coastal property that could be developed, you would get as much coastal property as you could, because as we see the world evolving and expanding and growing, they are becoming more and more scarce. And guess what? As they become more scarce and demand increases, guess what? Price is increasing as well. So Bitcoin in the same manner is scarce in supply. Currently at the moment, there are 12.5 Bitcoin that's released into the global economy every 10 minutes. So every 10 minutes, there are 12.5 Bitcoin that's released into the global economy. Now, here's the thing about Bitcoin. I said just now that it's finite in supply. Well, by the year 2140, you won't be able to mine any more Bitcoin and get your hands on Bitcoin. And as you're seeing right now, because the supply is becoming more and more difficult to produce Bitcoin, and as demand is increasing, we're seeing the price go through the roof. So what exactly is Bitcoin? Well, I said just now that it is a digital currency. And in a simple form, all I want you to think about is that just as money evolved, Bitcoin is a currency that you can use to pay for goods. It is a payment method that you can use. So let's have a look at a little video which explains what Bitcoin is about.
What is Bitcoin? Bitcoin is the first decentralized digital currency. Bitcoins are digital coins you can send through the internet. Compared to other alternatives, Bitcoins have a number of advantages. Bitcoins are transferred directly from person to person via the net, without going through a bank or clearinghouse. This means that the fees are much lower. You can use them in every country. Your account cannot be frozen, and there are no prerequisites or arbitrary limits. Let's look at how it works. Several currency exchanges exist where you can buy and sell Bitcoins for dollars, euros, and more. Your Bitcoins are kept in your digital wallet on your computer or mobile device. Sending Bitcoins is as simple as sending an email, and you can purchase anything with Bitcoin. The Bitcoin network is secured by individuals called miners. Miners are rewarded newly generated Bitcoins for verifying transactions. After transactions are verified, they are recorded in a transparent public ledger. Bitcoin opens up a whole new platform for innovation. The software is completely open source and anyone can review the code. Bitcoin is changing finance the same way the web changed publishing. When everyone has access to a global market, great ideas flourish. Bitcoins are a great way for businesses to minimize transaction fees. It doesn't cost anything to start accepting them, and it's easy to set up. There are no chargebacks, and you'll get additional business from the Bitcoin economy. For more information about Bitcoin, visit weusecoins.com.
Okay, so the most important statement for me in that video was that what the web did for publishing Bitcoin is doing for finance. Now, that's a big statement because the internet changed the way the whole world operates. And if you look at that statement, Bitcoin is also changing the way that we're doing money right now. And in a very simple nutshell, all you need to understand about Bitcoin is that it is a currency that you can use to make payment. It is just, it is a new form of money. Well, relatively new, because as we saw, the first Bitcoin was mined in the first January 2009. Now, you're not going to understand every single thing about Bitcoin. Just like you don't understand exactly how the internet works, like when you Google something, how is it that within a few seconds, Google has the answers, and you're not going to understand everything about Bitcoin. Just like when you switch on the light switch, you don't understand how electricity moves from one point to the other. You just know that when you put on the light switch, there's light in your house and you're able to see what you're doing as opposed to being in the dark and crashing into the chair in front of you. Okay, so you're never going to understand every single thing about Bitcoin. Now, you're going to have questions about where does it come from? How does it move across the blockchain? How does it actually get mined? We're going to cover the very basics during the time that we have together. But I just want to let you know that you're never going to understand every single thing about it. But just because you don't understand everything fully, don't be hesitant. Don't think that this is above what is beyond your capability of being able to figure it out, because we're going to get into the basics of it. And just for now, know that Bitcoin is a new form of money that is able to be transferred over the internet from one point to another, that is cheaper than using a bank, and it is also faster than using a bank. So we'll get into some of those things just now, but let's look at what is it that gives Bitcoin its value. Well, the value behind Bitcoin is this thing called blockchain technology. Now, what is blockchain technology? As I said earlier just now, you're not going to understand every single thing about Bitcoin. In the same way, we're not going to understand every single thing about blockchain technology. But in a very simple form, blockchain technology is being described by the men that you see on screen, Bill Gates and Richard Branson, as the next evolution of the internet. They call blockchain technology as superpowering the internet. So can you imagine what this blockchain technology is going to be about? If it is the next evolution of the internet, then that's going to be radical. And why is this blockchain technology so powerful? Now, let's think about 20 years ago. Think about 20 years ago when you wanted to write a letter and you wanted to post it to someone in a different state, different county, or even in a different country. You would write the letter, you would put it in an envelope, you would go to the post office, you would mail it, and that letter would leave you and it would then go into the hands of the person that you are sending it to. Now, when that was done, that letter moved from being in your home or your office to the person you were sending it to, meaning that you didn't have that copy. It was only one letter. Currently, when we look at the internet right now, if you send an email, if you send information over the net, if you are sending a Excel spreadsheet or Microsoft Word document, whenever you are sending information over the net, what happens is that there are two points. There's a sending point, that is you sending the email, and that is the other point is the recipient, the person who receives the email from you. Now, what happens is that when you send the email, there is a copy of the email on your side, and the recipient, the person who receives the email from you, also has the copy of that email. The identical same email. That means that information which is sent over the internet is stored in two different places. Now, here's what the blockchain technology does. The blockchain technology enabled information to be sent over the internet from one point to the other point without there being duplicate copies. I want you to think about that. So just as you would send the mail from, if we go back 25 years ago, if you were writing a postcard or a handwritten mail, and you send it from your home or office to someone abroad, there's only one copy. Now with the blockchain technology, we are able to copy that system where we're able to send information over the internet without there being a duplicate copy. And that has changed the game. So don't listen to what I'm saying about blockchain technology or Bitcoin or these cryptocurrencies, or even what Adrian has to say, or even what other people anywhere around the world have to say. Let's listen to some of the experts in the industry, like the Richard Branson, like the Bill Gates, like some of the Silicon Valley investors who have already put money into Bitcoin. And we'll listen to them just now. But first, let's have a look at the charts of what Bitcoin has been doing only in the last 2 years. As you can see, at the end of 2015, Bitcoin had a value of plus minus $450. And as you can see on the chart, it's been in an upward spiral. And as at July 2017, it went up to plus minus $2,500. So at the end of 2015, from $450 to 18 months later to $2,500 to right now, the 1st of November, a value of approximately $6,300. So in a short period of time, Bitcoin has gone up by huge market falls. In fact, it's actually $6,600 as we speak right now. So what is it that's driving up this price? Why is it that there's so much demand for this Bitcoin? Why is this thing in such high demand? And what do the experts have to say? Well, again, don't listen to what I have to say. Don't listen to what Adrian has to say. Don't listen to what anybody else has to say. But let's listen to the guys who've actually made not just millions, but hundreds of millions as entrepreneurs and investors, and see what they have to say. Because these are the guys who spot opportunities. These are the guys who spot trends. Let's listen to what they have to say. And before we get to that, let's have a look at this thing called inflation. So in 1998, if I had given you probably £100 or $100, you would be able to get a basket for a trolley full of goods from your local supermarket down the road. 2005, maybe you were able to get half a trolley full. However, in 2013, or even right now, you might not get as many goods as you were able to get for the same amount of money in 1998. But why is that so? It's the same £100 or the same $100, but why is it giving us less goods? That's because of this thing called inflation. Remember what I said earlier, as governments want more money, they print more money, which might not equate to the value of, which might not equate to the value in that economy. And they just keep printing money. Although they're supposed to only print money according to the gold supply that's held in their reserves, we all know that that isn't the case right now. Classic example of that is Zimbabwe. Now let's compare that to Bitcoin. In 2011, 2 years after Bitcoin was invented, wasn't worth very much. Maybe a couple cents. Maybe you'd be able to get one or two items from your supermarket down the road. 2013, you know what? The price went up a little bit. You know, maybe you'd be able to get a few more goods from the supermarket. In 2014, if you take a Bitcoin, let's leave 2014. If you take one Bitcoin right now and you go to your local supermarket, you can get trolleys full of goods from there. In fact, with one Bitcoin, you can probably even purchase a car, dependent on where you are in the world right now. So Bitcoin has been appreciating in value, whereas paper money, or what we refer to as fiat currency, depreciates in value. And if you're thinking, hey, Bitcoin is $6,600 right now, have I missed the boat? Well, let's listen to what Nicholas Carey, the CEO of blockchain, has to say. He says that today Bitcoin is just starting to enter the investment phase. So where is Bitcoin headed? Let's listen to what some of the experts have to say. The Bransons, the Bill Gates, the Silicon Valley investors. And as we get to that, let's look at the product adoption curve of any product. Whenever any product or any new innovation is put into the market, if you look on the left side of your screen right now, you'll see that there's only a few people who get into it, the innovators. And then it, as it becomes more popular, yes, certain people start investing in it, and these are called the early adopters. And then later on, you get the masses coming into it, which are the early majority, which is the middle of the curve, and then the late majority. A typical example of this would be Facebook. Now, if I asked you right now, when did you start using Facebook? Most people would probably say 2007, 2008. However, Facebook has been around since 2002, 2003, but not many people knew about it. Though that was at the innovator stage. Then came along the early adopters, the guys who started getting in 2005. And then the early majority, people started jumping into Facebook. And then the late majority, people who say that, oh, I'm never going to share my photos on Facebook. I'm not gonna see what other people are doing. And then you still get the skeptics who think that, Facebook is not a real thing, but they still get onto it. So where are we right now with Bitcoin? We are here. We are right between the innovators and the early adopters. Now, think about that. What does it mean for the price that we see? If we are still at the between the innovator and the early adopter stage, and we think that the price of $6,600 is quite high, where is this headed? And what's going to happen? So let's look and let's listen to what the Bransons and the Bill Gates and the Silicon Valley investors have to say about Bitcoin as we get into it. And I know this video right now for you guys might not have a lot of sound. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to share. Just bear with me as I move screens, because I want you to be able to see the video on the screen from where I'm sharing. Okay, so let me know. Adrian, if you can just let me know, can you see the new video that I've pulled up?
Yeah, I'm not sure what the sound quality, if it's that good, mine, but...
Okay, we'll go for it now. I think this should be good, so let's go for it on this one, okay? Just let me know if the sound quality isn't too good, though.
As the dollar and the euro continue their slow path to recovery...
No, it's not the best sound quality, Yilesh.
Oh, okay.
Can you run it from the direct link on YouTube or whatever the link is?
Yeah, I'm actually running it from that link right now. Let's see.
You want to send the link to me so I can run it my end?
Okay, sure. I'm just going to drop it in the chat right now.
You had the same problem last week, didn't we? I don't know why.
Yeah, yeah. So that's why I thought I'd actually run it on this one, but it's...
Satoshi. Okay, I'll share my screen now, okay?
Okay, sure.
As the dollar and the euro continue their slow path to recovery, some people are trading in their money for a currency that is already booming. It's called Bitcoin, and it's the currency of the internet. Invented 5 years ago by an anonymous programmer, Bitcoin has no government tied to it, no delay when sending money, and few, if any, transaction fees. And while many people still may not consider Bitcoin real money, it's making some people really rich.
A Satoshi invented one of the most important inventions in the entire history of humankind that's going to improve the lives of everybody on the planet for the better. It undermines the ability of every single government on the entire planet to control the money supply. And that's how every single government in the world is controlling their citizens and their economies today. And he just basically you know, knocked their feet right out from under them with the invention of Bitcoin. And it probably would have been smarter for me to keep quiet too, but Bitcoin's too exciting for me to stay quiet about.
But Bitcoin and things like it is the equivalent of the red pill. Okay? We are entering a completely world of uncharted water.
Have you made any investments in Bitcoin?
So, I mean, I personally own Bitcoin in my hedge fund. I own Bitcoin in my fund. I own Bitcoin in my private account. It is a huge deal. It's a huge, huge, huge deal. Because what you're talking about right now is for the next 3 to 5 years, an unbelievably better store value. It is gold 2.0. Where, Lena, you and I have decided that it's worth $1,300 an ounce. Well, guess what? I can do the same thing with Bitcoin, except now I can do it outside the purview of every single government.
This is a currency that's really going to work eventually.
Well, I think it is working. And there will be other currencies like it that may be even better. But in the meantime, there's a big industry around Bitcoin. And you know, people have made fortunes out of Bitcoin.
Bitcoin, there is no Bitcoin company. There is no Bitcoin building. There's even not even a Bitcoin server anywhere that you could shut down. It is completely distributed. That's what's unique about Bitcoin. It is, for the first time, a way for the two of us to exchange value online without a third-party intermediary. Until the invention of Bitcoin, for you and me to exchange money online, we had to employ a third party, like PayPal, like Visa, like MasterCard, right? And we live in the 21st century. If we want to have a video call to China, we can do that for free. But to send a couple $100, which is essentially just ones and zeros being moved around, costs 5% plus takes over a day.
Bitcoin is exciting because it shows how cheap it can be. Bitcoin is better than currency in that you don't have to be physically in the same place. And of course, for large transactions, currency can get pretty inconvenient.
You'll see Bitcoin trading at 1,000, 2,000, 5,000, 10,000. Rick Falkvigna does an excellent analysis. He predicts that Bitcoin will capture between 1 and 10% of the global Forex market, which implies a price of between $100,000 to $1 million per Bitcoin. Most of the people who are on the sidelines not buying Bitcoin today will start to buy Bitcoin when it gets over 1,000. And then a greater percentage of people will definitely plow into Bitcoin when it starts to get over 10,000.
I'm still predicting Bitcoin, $10,000 per Bitcoin in 3 years.
Saras, he's the CEO of Zappo, which is a Bitcoin wallet and Bitcoin vault.
I think it's mostly a very positive thing. I think we're going to see ups and downs like with any other emerging technology. But I think Bitcoin is here to stay. And
so let's make a boat call here. In 10 years, what do you think Bitcoin will be worth? One Bitcoin.
Between $500,000 and $1 million.
How big a market share can Bitcoin realistically take within a foreseeable time frame? When you ask that question, then you come up with a market cap of Bitcoin total. And then you divide that by the number of Bitcoin in circulation by your estimated time. And seeing how Chinese are buying Bitcoin like crazy, actually have to adjust this number upwards. But then you come up with a number of about $2 to $5 million per Bitcoin.
Is Bitcoin the currency of the future? Or is it the payment system they're developing?
Bingo, it's the payment system. It's the blockchain encryption. And there are interesting things. I think Bitcoin, or the really blockchain encryption that's behind it, has a greater ability to bring more of the world's population out of poverty than anything we've seen. It's not too late to get involved with Bitcoin. If Bitcoin becomes really popular all over the world, Bitcoins are going to have to be worth at least tens of thousands of dollars a Bitcoin, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars per Bitcoin. So thinking it's too late to get involved with Bitcoin is like thinking it's too late to get involved with using the internet. Of course not. Like it's ubiquitous in our lives, and Bitcoin's going to become ubiquitous in our lives as well.
You can buy Bitcoin in the Shell station. Check it out. Is it?
Got my other.
Oh, I got the cash.
Good.
Got $2. Finished.
Oh.
$2 Bitcoin. Just like that.
This machine.
I just turned cash into digital currency.
If you're new to Bitcoin, take your time to go out there and Google it and learn about it. It truly is one of the most important inventions in the history of humankind, and certainly the most important invention since the internet. Go out there, make a Bitcoin wallet, get involved, start using it, learn about all the positive ways in which this is going to improve the lives of every single person on the planet. Get involved, do it today. It's going to help everybody. Thank you.
Okay, Nilesh. Are you still there, Nilesh? Hold on, let me just see if I muted him. There you go, Nilesh, back to you, mate.
Okay, thanks so much for that, Adrian. Great. So I'm just gonna get back to my screen share here. So let me know when you can see it on your side, Adrian.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, brilliant. So if you're watching this, you just heard what some of the brightest minds in the world have to say about Bitcoin. And Bill Gates himself in that video said that Bitcoin is better than currency. If you didn't catch that, go back and find and go see that video. Other guys in that video said that thinking that it's too late to get involved in Bitcoin is thinking that it's too late to start using the internet. It's never too late. So if you're watching this right now, you are in the right place at the right time, because not only is it still at a very early stage in terms of people profiting with Bitcoin, but most people don't know how to start using Bitcoin and profit with it. So how do you actually get Bitcoin? First way that you can make money from Bitcoin is you can trade Bitcoin. Now, this is high risk. Why do we say that? Because trading by nature is risky. Add into that mix a volatile currency like Bitcoin, which goes up and down on a daily basis. In the Forex market, people, you know, a 2% movement is considered, quite significant. However, Bitcoin in a day can move from anywhere 5 to 20% in a day. So try trading that to make money. Yes, you can make money. However, it is risky in the sense that it is time consuming as well. You need to be in front of your computer watching your screens to see, you know, when is it that you are going to buy? When is it that you're going to sell? And also, when you sell your Bitcoin, how do you get more Bitcoin? Because if the price is going up again, you're going to buy it at a higher price. So trading is very high risk. The second option to get Bitcoin is to mine Bitcoin. So what do we mean by mining Bitcoin? Very simple. Mining Bitcoin is actually producing the Bitcoin. So think of it as, when you mine gold or mine diamonds from the ground, you need equipment to get the diamonds and the gold from the ground. In the same way, when we mine Bitcoin, we need equipment, which in today's world are computers that mine this Bitcoin for us. They do all of the work for us. So for right now, just know that mining Bitcoin is producing Bitcoin. So we'll dive into what mining is as we move along. But the third thing, or the third strategy that a lot of people also use, is they'll just buy Bitcoin and hold it. Now, here's the thing with buying and holding. If the price goes up, yes, you did make money. But what if you took the same amount of money that you used to buy the Bitcoin and you use it to produce a Bitcoin, and in 2 years' time, or even a year's time, a year and a half, 2 years' time, you reach a point where the mining of it surpasses the buying and holding strategy. Now, what do I mean by that? Let's say you took $6,600 today and you use it to purchase one Bitcoin. All you would do is you would be stuck with one Bitcoin. in 2 years' time, you still have one Bitcoin. However, if you are mining your Bitcoin, you took the same $6,600, you use it to purchase mining equipment. Perhaps in a year and a half, 2 years' time, you won't just have one Bitcoin. You might have, hypothetically speaking, I don't know, might have 1.2, might have 1.3, 1.4, 1.5. I don't know what the figure could be. But mining, from historical results and what we've seen, can surpass the buying and holding of Bitcoin. So for now, all you need to know is that mining Bitcoin is producing Bitcoin. Let's keep it simple. We just like when we switch a light switch on, all we need to know is that light comes into the room that enables us to see, and we don't get involved with the how many gigawatts is going on and the whole electricity box and you know all of those things. Let's keep it simple. Okay, that's all we need to know. So let's have a listen to see what is Bitcoin mining about, and in this short little video.
What is Bitcoin mining? Bitcoin operates as a peer-to-peer network. This means that everyone who uses Bitcoin is a tiny fraction of the bank of Bitcoin. But where do Bitcoins come from? With paper money, a government decides when to print and distribute money. Bitcoin doesn't have a central government. With Bitcoin, miners use special software to solve math problems and are issued a certain number of Bitcoins in exchange. This provides a smart way to issue the currency and also creates an incentive for more people to mine. And since miners are required to approve Bitcoin transactions, more miners means a more secure network. The Bitcoin network automatically changes the difficulty of the math problems, depending on how fast they're being solved. In the early days, Bitcoin miners solved these math problems with the processors in their computers. Soon, miners discovered that graphics cards used for gaming were much better suited to this kind of math. Graphics cards are faster, they use more electricity, and generate a lot of heat. The first commercial Bitcoin mining products included chips that were reprogrammed for mining Bitcoin. These chips were faster, but still power-hungry. ASIC, or application-specific integrated circuit chips, are designed specifically for Bitcoin mining. ASIC technology has made Bitcoin mining even faster while using less power. As the popularity of Bitcoin increases, more miners join the network, making it more difficult for individuals to solve the math problems. To overcome this, miners have developed a way to work together in pools. Pools of miners find solutions faster than their individual members, and each miner is rewarded proportionate to the amount of work he or she provides. Mining is an important and integral part of Bitcoin that ensures fairness while keeping the Bitcoin network stable, safe, and secure. For more information about Bitcoin mining, visit bitcoinmining.com.
Okay, so that video just gave us a short explanation of what Bitcoin mining actually is, and I'm just going to sum it up for you. So now that you know what Bitcoin is, you know that it is a currency, which any currency is money. And Bitcoin mining, as we said earlier, is producing Bitcoin. So we are producing the currency. How do we produce Bitcoin? We produce it with hardware, which are computers. Now, these computers, they do not do anything else other than mine Bitcoin for you. So right now, you're probably saying, hey, hold up, Nilesh, I don't understand what mining is about. Well, in a very simplified form, here's what mining does. Okay, here's how we get the Bitcoin. Produced through mining. There's this algorithm that's in the air, in the cloud technology. Okay, everything today is in cloud-based technology. So there's this algorithm that's sitting there. And every time this algorithm is solved successfully by your machinery, your equipment, your computer, you are rewarded with a piece of a Bitcoin or a Bitcoin. Now, if you try to do this, you saw in the video as well that pool mining is actually groups of miners that work together to combine their power so that they can solve the algorithm quicker. Because it's not just you trying to solve this algorithm, it's the other hundreds of thousands of people around the world also trying to solve this algorithm to compete to get the Bitcoin. And whoever solves the algorithm the quickest is rewarded with the Bitcoin. That means not everyone is rewarded. So those who pool their resources into bigger mining communities are more likely to be successful in mining Bitcoin at a better rate. Now, mining is, you for mining, you also reward it for verifying transactions. Just like when you pay money at the bank to another bank, both parties, both banks charge fees. Guess what? As miners, for verifying transactions in the blockchain network, that means every time Bitcoin is moved, for verifying those transactions, we're also rewarded with a piece of a Bitcoin. Now, why is that huge for mining? Because, my friends, as more and more people are adopting Bitcoin, as more and more people are becoming aware of Bitcoin, as Bitcoin market cap is growing on a daily basis, guess what? We have more need for miners because there are more transactions to verify. So not only now are we solving the algorithm to get rewarded in Bitcoin, but we also verify more transactions. More transactions means we're rewarded with more Bitcoin. Now, when you want to verify the mining, you can go to this pie chart that you see here on the blockchain site. And as you can see on the blockchain pie chart, you can see all of the miners involved in mining Bitcoin. On the right-hand side of this pie chart, you will notice that those slices are quite bigger because those are the bigger miners. And on the left-hand side are smaller slices. So what are the biggest problems with mining Bitcoin? And what are the biggest problems with mining Bitcoin right now? Well, here's the first thing. When you are going onto a site and you are giving your money to a site, you don't know who the owners of that site are. So what happens 6 months, 8 months, a year and a half down the line? Guess what? You go to look into the site and it's closed down. Can't log into it. But you put money there and you had Bitcoins there and now it's gone. Okay, that's just part of the industry that we're in. Second big problem that we have in this industry right now is that there are unscrupulous companies that exist. They will deliberately put up a site, get you to put money in, promise that they are doing Bitcoin mining, and promise you these fantastic rewards, which are beyond the scope of legitimate mining. And once people put money in, again, a couple months down the line, a year down the line, I don't know how long it could be, but then the companies are, the websites gone. What recourse do you have? You don't know who the owners are. You've never seen them. You've never met them. You don't know if it's a registered company. There's no head office. Yes, you might see some nice pretty pictures on the website, but have you seen it for real? No. What recourse do you have? Zero. Nothing you can do. Third problem in this industry is that companies might be too small. Now, remember I said just now that in that video, they spoke about pool mining, because just as everyone is trying to compete to solve this algorithm, not everyone is going to succeed. And those who don't succeed, they're not getting rewarded with a piece of a Bitcoin or a Bitcoin. And guess what? They still have costs. They still have expenses. They get to a point where their expenses exceed their profits. And all of a sudden, it's not worthwhile to do Bitcoin mining for them anymore. Fourth problem in this industry is security. Great. How do you know that the company that you are with is not going to get hacked? Or how do you know that the exchange that you're on is secure? That is another problem that we have in this industry. So the company that we're going to be speaking about right now is LifeStyle Galaxy. And that's who I mine with. That's who Adrian is mining with right now as well. And a few others who might be on this call. And this company was founded by David Martin, who specializes in banking security software. David Martin is a British citizen who moved to the US many years ago, and he was involved in banking security software. He made millions in the industry. He's a techno geek. He's a bright mind. Quite frankly, he's a boffin and a nerd. Okay, so that's why he's so good in this technology space. And he founded a company in 2008, which we rebranded as LifeStyle Galaxy, and this company was founded in 2008 by him. So this company has been around for 9 years this year. So next year it's going to be 10 years, a full decade. So David, whilst he has the technical expertise, realized that, hey, having a company is not just about being technically savvy. To run a company profitably, you're going to need good leadership. So he hired Ken Brough. He personally headhunted him. Ken Brough is the CEO of the company. He's the ex-vice president of some of Tony Robbins' businesses, and he's held executive roles in two Fortune 500 companies. So we've got good corporate status, good corporate leadership, should I say, in the company. The company of Lifestyle Galaxy, again, as I told you, founded in 2008 by David Martin. It is debt-free. We do not owe, the company does not owe anyone any money. It is privately funded. And we sell wholesale Galaxy mining products, mining contracts, should I say. And we also have a wide diversity of products. So we do a whole bunch of other things apart from just Bitcoin and cryptocurrency mining. And here are some of the people who are involved in Lifestyle Galaxy at the moment. These are people from South Africa who I've personally met. As you can see, they are based in different parts of in South Africa, Johannesburg, Cape Town, Durban. And Adrian has personally been on calls with guys here like Andrew Eaton, Tony de Gouveia. He's in some groups with Doc Ant as well. I've personally met all of these people. And Andrew Eaton is the guy that brought this company to South Africa in 2011, if I'm not mistaken. So we are a real company with real people. And for those who might be wondering, okay, great, Nilesh, I've seen some of the people who are in this company, but what about the leadership? Show me, tell me about David Martin. Tell me about Ken Brough. How do I know that they are real people? Well, there's a picture of Ken Brough, who you would have seen a couple of slides ago. That's me with Ken Brough. He's a real person. David Martin is a real person as well. So here's a couple of pictures of Andrew Eaton, Jacques Sasson, and Tony de Gouveia with David Martin in Las Vegas last year. And he's a real person. A real person, a real company, a real mining equipment, real mining operation that we run. Here's a company event. Again, you can see David Martin on your left, third from the left, standing. He's a real person with Andrew Eaton. He's there. And you can see Ken Brough, fifth person from your left, sitting down in this picture as well. And Adrian and myself are going to meet both David Martin and Ken Brough in Vegas in just under 2 weeks' time. We're going to meet them both in Las Vegas in just under 2 weeks' time. And we are actually going to visit the mining operation in about 3 weeks' time as well. So this is a real company, real people with real mining equipment. That's why we are able to get people to come in and say, hey, if you want to see how real this company is, come to Vegas, meet the founder, meet the executive team leadership, meet the corporate leadership. If you want to come and if you're lucky to be personally invited to the mining farm, then grab it. This is real. Come and touch your equipment. Come and touch it, see it, and see how real this operation is. So with that said, why is Lifestyle Galaxy having such good success right now? Well, we are trusted and secure. We are branded as the safest mining operation in the world. Why is that so? Because we're the first mine in the world to actually put faces on the company website, allow people to meet the company founder and the corporate leadership, and the first company in the world that is actually allowing their members to go in and visit the mining operation and touch and feel and see the equipment that belongs to the members. We're the first company in the world to do that. Why are we doing that? Well, why can we do that? Because it's real. It's real, my friends. This is real. And we are branded as the safest mining operation in the world. So how did we achieve what we've achieved? We've partnered with the best and most reputable professionals in the industry who have the largest mines in America. Our mining partner has been mining since 2011. So that means there is a track record of 6 years of mining Bitcoin and cryptocurrency. That means there's experience that's gone on in this industry that we are able to take advantage of. as I've told you, mining successfully since 2011. And what we allow you to do is we allow you to purchase the hardware that will be installed in the mining farm and that will be maintained for you. That means you are able to produce your own Bitcoin, your own Bitcoins or cryptocurrency with our mining operation. And that's why we are one of the most or the most trusted and secure mining operation in the world. So, Galaxy Mining offers you the ability to mine not just Bitcoin, but other altcoins like Ethereum, like Litecoin, like Expanse, like Zcash, as well as other coins that are going to be introduced into our mining platform. We are secure because David Martin's expertise in the banking security software industry has allowed us to create a system that is very, very, very secure. And we are the most trusted real mining operation in the world. But over and above that, what makes us really stand out from any other mining operation is that we have a growth strategy of compounding, which will allow us to be in the top five mining in the pie chart that you saw earlier. We're going to be in the top five in the world by the year 2020 because we have a vision and a strategy that we are following to get there. So Tony Beware, who's our director of marketing, said money will always flow to the safe haven, to what is trusted. And that's why we do what we do. We are a trusted brand, safe and secure. Everything that we do is following the protocol of following regulations, following the legal complexities that need to be adhered to, and doing things above board. That's what we are about. That's why we are safe, trusted, and secure. So how real is this? Okay, sure, Adrian's gonna visit there in a couple of weeks of time. I'm gonna be visiting there, but are there other people that have already been to this mine? And the answer is yes. So what I'm gonna do, Adrian, if you can just please play this, because I know the sound on this one isn't too good either. I'm gonna just drop this into the chat roll for you. And if you can play this on your side, so everyone can hear the good sound as well. And the video that we're going to play for you right now, Adrian's going to play for you, is Andrew Eaton actually visiting the Bitcoin mine here in America. Let's have a look.
Sorry about that, Nilesh. The video kicked in.
No worries.
Right now, okay?
Okay, so for the guys watching right now, this is how real it is. This is a real mine. This is the mine that we own in America. And this is Andrew Eaton visiting the mine. And this is what a real mining operation looks like, which Adrian and I are going to be visiting with along with a couple of other people in a couple of weeks' time. And let's have a look at it. Adrian, over to you. Thanks.
What I want to say to everyone, everything that you see inside here now, everything, and this is just one of our facilities, everything inside here belongs to Galaxy Mine, previously known as Dragon Mine. Okay, it's been a huge privilege for us to be here, freezing cold. So what I'm going to do is quickly take you inside and show you some stuff. It's going to be very loud inside. I'll be able to see some of the cooling systems, the fans that suck the air in to keep it cool. I'm going to take you inside, and I'm not going to say much, but it's very loud inside, guys. Just know that this is very real. Now let's go show you the real. Come. So, if you look over here, these are all the GPUs that are mining altcoins. As Tony said, at the top here, those are the hand miners that are mining your Bitcoin. Tony, you just said your Bitcoin, your alt currencies. And we understand how powerful this is. We understand that each one of these belongs to someone in our community. Each one of these belongs to someone in our Galaxy Mining community. And it's incredibly powerful. Well, let's go show you a couple of $1 million worth of mining equipment. There are literally thousands here, Tony. Thousands.
bricks. Thousands of bricks, right? It doesn't go bad. So it's very loud inside here, so I don't want to make this video too long. But just know, this is yours. This is yours. And we're just getting started. So anyone ever says to you, is it real? Right? Look.
Okay, just bear with me. Okay, back to you, Nilesh.
Okay, thanks for that, Adrian. So,
new virtual gold rush is underway, and this is the equipment the miners are banking on to make them rich. Bitcoin is a virtual currency that is.
Okay, so let me know when you can see my screen.
Okay, yeah, that's fine.
Brilliant. So if you watch that video, guys, you'd see that that was what a real Bitcoin mine looks like. And Andrew Eaton was in there, and Adrian and I and a couple of other people are going to be visiting that mine in a few weeks' time. This is real. When you put in your money in this company, that's what your money is used for. It is used to buy your equipment, to buy a mining contract. When you buy a mining contract, that's what you buy. You buy equipment that belongs to you. And we can go and pinpoint your mining equipment. We can go to warehouse number 2, rack 24, on row number 2, number 3. Here is your equipment with your name on it. That's how real this is. So how do you participate and how do you start mining with Lifestyle Galaxy? Well, to participate and start mining with Lifestyle Galaxy, you need to become a member of the Value Club, which is $600 in countries like South Africa and Malaysia. However, I know in the UK, as well as some other countries, it is $400. And the reason for that is because we are newly launching in those countries. So countries like South Africa some other countries where we are established, the launch price is no longer available and the price is $600. However, if you're watching this in the UK, or a country where we are doing a launch special, it is $400. Once you pay your $400 to become a Value Club member, now the Value Club member, the $400 enables you to become a Value Club member, which gives you access to not just mining packages, but also a whole host of other products that we have. Once you pay your $400, you are able to purchase a mining package, which starts from $500. You can purchase as many packages as you want or as many mining contracts as you want. You're not limited to $500. You can currently, the different packages or mining contracts that we have right now are $500, $1,000, $2,000, $2,500, $5,000, and $10,000. So you can buy as many of these contracts as you want, and we will be adding in $25,000, $50,000, and $100,000 contracts in here, because in the last few months we've had a huge demand for that. So we will be adding those in fairly shortly. I expect that to be announced after the Vegas corporate event. So remember that your $600 or your $400 Value Club membership fee is once off for your entire lifetime. You never have to pay that again. You're welcome to purchase as many mining contracts as you want, starting from $500. This is just an example of what your back office looks like, where you are able to monitor the performance of your mining contract. As you can see, this is just another example of your back office. You have a summary of 24 hours, 7 days, and 30 days, meaning that you can see how well your equipment, because remember, what is your money used for? Once you buy a mining contract, it is used to purchase the equipment which mines for you. Now, this equipment, it doesn't do email, it doesn't do internet, it doesn't do Excel spreadsheets, it doesn't do any of that stuff. All it does is that it mines Bitcoin for you. Now, Galaxy Mines' vision is to be one of the biggest mining pools on the blockchain by 2020. Now, how are we able to achieve this? And we are actually on track to do this. Remember, I told you earlier that we're going to be in the top 5 on that pie chart on the blockchain. Well, here's our secret strategy. We use the repurchase compounding strategy, which is a minimum of 35% of all Bitcoins and altcoins that are mined daily are used to repurchase, are used to make your computer faster. So when you see GHS and MHS, just know that that is used to make your computer faster so that you are able to mine at a faster rate. But also what it does is that, remember, with equipment, we need to replace it every 3 years. So part of the money that is being compounded is also used to replace your equipment in 3 years. That means that when you buy a $10,000 contract today, in 3 years' time, you don't have to come back and say, hey, I'm going to buy another $10,000 contract. No. Because you are compounding on a daily basis, you are not only increasing your ability to mine more Bitcoin on a daily basis, but part of that money is kept to repurchase equipment for you at the end of 3 years, because we all know that equipment needs to be updated. So the repurchase compounding strategy will always ensure that your Bitcoin mining is always growing on a daily basis. So even if you do nothing today, all you do is just buy, join the value club and buy a mining package, your mining capacity is going to grow, meaning your ability to mine more and more Bitcoins is going to grow because of the repurchase compounding strategy. Now, there's two strategies that we use to grow our mining capacity, to grow our pool of miners. Number one is the repurchase compounding strategy, which every person who's mining Bitcoins is doing. That means on a daily basis, every single purchase, every single person is repurchasing through this compounding strategy, growing our mining capacity. And the second option, which is strategy two, is to grow the mining community. We want more people to come on board with Galaxy Mining so they can start mining with LifeStyle Galaxy. And as they start mining, they are repurchasing and compounding, meaning that the mining capacity of everyone in the community grows bigger. As the mining capacity of everyone in the community grows bigger, guess what? We are able to get more and more Bitcoin. We're able to get more and more altcoins, which means you start earning or you start producing more. So why would you want to tell your friends or your family about Galaxy Mining? Well, here's the thing. We've seen the effects of what's happening with paper money, whether it's a dollar, euro, yen, rand, whatever it is, compared to what's going on with cryptocurrency. Cryptocurrency in recent times has been appreciating in value, whereas all of those other currencies have been depreciating. So if you help them to get out of those currencies into cryptocurrency, you're doing them a favor. The second thing that you would be doing when you tell your friends about Galaxy Mining or your family is that you'd be helping grow the mining pool so we can all benefit, meaning we all start mining more and more Bitcoin and altcoins quicker. So if that's the only reason you tell your friends and family about Galaxy Mining, that would be a great reason. But guess what? Galaxy Mining incentivizes us as well. Here's what happens. When you tell your friend or your family member about us and they come on and they buy a Value Club membership for $400, here's what happens. You will get a once-off commission of $150 for someone who joins the Value Club. Whether they pay the $400 or the $600, you will get a once-off commission of $150. The second thing that will happen is that you will be generating, or you have the ability to generate, an ongoing residual income from all miners who are mining in the mining community. Now, this is called strategy two. What we're speaking about now is called strategy two. In order to do strategy two, you need to have a monthly membership activated of $30. Now, here's how it works. When you grow the mining community, you're going to get $150 for each Value Club membership. So anyone who joins the Value Club, you are going to get $150 when they join because of you. But here's what also happens. You are going to get club points into your LifeStyle Galaxy business. Now, CV points is just another way of what I like to refer to as club points. Now, I know different companies like Amazon and a lot of the big companies out there have reward points where the more you shop with them, they give you more points. And when your points reach a certain value, you're able to cash it in for maybe a discount or a physical product or whatever it is. Now, that's just called, that's just another way in this new world, which is used to give benefits to members. So in the same way, we have the CV points, which I like to refer to as club points. Each time someone new joins the value club, you get a 450 CV when they join in on a $600 package, which is once off. When they join in on a $400 package, you get 200 CV, which is 200 club points. Okay. Now, here's how your club points can start growing daily, weekly, and monthly, depending on the size of the contracts of the mining packages. When people mine, it is possible to get club points from them repurchasing mining power. You can get 2 club points, 3 club points, 4 club points, 10 club points. And this can happen on a daily, weekly, and a monthly basis, which means you are generating club points automatically daily, weekly, or monthly. So let's have a look at how this works. In the back office, as you can see, when someone pays a monthly fee of $30, those $30 turns into 30 club points. When someone joins on a $600 package, you get 450 club points. When someone joins on a $400 package, you get 200 club points. When someone is mining, as you can see an example of, 2 club points that come into the tree. Here's an example of someone who's mining who brings in 19 club points on a daily basis. Now, why is their club points going to be coming in on a daily, weekly, and monthly basis? Because guess what? In the mining structure that we run, the attrition rate of people leaving this business is zero. That means once people start mining, they keep mining because they keep compounding, they keep repurchasing more gigahash. And what happens when you actively grow the mining community? And we're going to close this up in a short while, so just bear with me as we bring this in for a landing. So what happens when you actively grow the mining community? Not only is your personal mining capacity growing daily, but your mining community grows as well. That means everybody's mining is growing. That means there's compounding growth. Now, Einstein said that the most powerful tool in the world is compounding. So you have the ability to earn quicker over a period of time. But how do these club points work? Let's have a look at it. Every time you hit 900 club points, you will achieve what is called one cycle. One cycle will give you $50. So in essence, 900 club points will give you $50 when you have a minimum of 300 club points on one leg of your binary system and 600 on the other leg of your binary system. Doesn't matter which leg has the minimum of 300 or 600. So let's have a look at how this works. So by the way, this is the points are accumulated to an unlimited depth. That means it doesn't matter who in your team brings in the miners to the community. So let's have a look, and let's say that's you. You personally sponsor Jack and Joe or tell them about the business. And they join Galaxy Mine because, hey, they see, hey, this is great. I want to get out of dollars, euro, yen, pounds, whatever, and I want to get into Bitcoin. I want to start mining. Guess what? You get $150 for introducing Jack and Joe, right? So Jack, in this example, is going to bring $450 CV into your business club points. Because this is assuming that he does the $600 membership. And that's because this example is based in South Africa. So you get $150 direct commission, but you also get 450 club points in your business. Joe also joins your business and she brings in $150 direct commission to you and you get 450 club points in your business. Now, in order for you to start cycling, you need to have personally introduced 2 members, one on your left and one on your right. Now, you've got 450 plus 450. That means you've got 900 club points. Will you cycle and get $50? Not yet. Because remember, you need a minimum of 300 on one leg and 600 on the other leg to start cycling. As you can see in this example, we don't have 600 on the other leg. Now, Jack says, hey, you know what? I'm loving my mining with Lifestyle Galaxy. I'm really seeing the compounding. You know, I'm benefiting. I'm really doing well. And so Jack introduces friend number one and friend number two into Lifestyle Galaxy. Guess what? Jack gets $150 because he introduced them into Lifestyle Galaxy. But guess what happens? You also gonna benefit from Jack introducing friend number one and friend number two. That means you also benefit from the 450 CV points that friend number one and friend number two brings in, which means you get an additional 900 points coming in. Jill also says, hey, I'm loving my mining with Lifestyle Galaxy. I love compounding. I love this mining of Bitcoin. And she introduces friend number one into Lifestyle Galaxy. She gets $150 because she's personally introduced friend number one. But guess what? You also benefit from 450 club points coming in into your business, because this is a binary structure. So that means you now have 1,350 points on one leg and 900 on the other leg, which means you are now able to cycle. That means you cycle two times. Now, if you add this up, that means you've got $300 from direct commissions and $100 from cycling, which means you've got $400. Now, let's say you personally introduce Dave into the mining, into the Value Club membership. You get $150 because you've personally introduced Dave. But guess what? Jack also benefits from 450 points being added into the business from your efforts, because this is a team effort. And he also gets the 450 points. This also means it now enables you to cycle one more time. And if we add the direct commission and the team commissions, you are able to get $600 with this little example based on the $600 club package. So I just want to bring that to your attention. Now, let's have a look at what John D. Rockefeller said. John D. Rockefeller said that I would rather earn 1% off 100 people's efforts than 100% off my own efforts. And that's called leverage. Because guess what? In today's world, we leverage the internet. We leverage a lot of things in today's world. So why not leverage through a network the ability to grow our mining community and get rewarded for it? Now, if we flip this example, if you have 100 people in your team and each person is just putting in an hour a day, you've got 100 hours that are being 100 productive hours versus if you were doing this yourself, you're limited to 24 hours. That's what Branson does. That's what Bill Gates does. That's exactly what Rockefeller was speaking about, is leverage your time through the network of people. Now, we're just going to get into an example on these two slides. But before we do that, I just want to make a disclaimer here that this example in no way guarantees that these rewards will be achieved by you. These are just hypothetical and will differ depending on your individual skill set and also the efforts of your team. However, this is possible. So let's have a look at this example where, say, this is you, and we're not even going to take into account the mining CV or mining club points from people who mine in this example. We're just going to look and say, let's say you have 10 active promoters, or you introduce 10 people into this Galaxy mining on the $600 package. They would each bring in 450 points. 10 times 450 points gives you 4,500 points. Divide by 900, because that's how many you need to cycle, which would give you an extra $250. Don't worry about the Rand value. Let's say that this grows into 100 people. Remember, this does not have to be 100 people personally introduced by you. This is you plus the efforts of the team. And that's why this is leverage. So 100 times 450 CV on the $600 package. We want to make sure that's very clear. Would give you 45,000 club points or CV divided by 900, because that's how many you need to cycle. Would give you 50 times $50, which is an extra $2,500. Please remember, that is not you personally introducing 100 people yourself. That is you plus the team. So that is growing with the team. So that is the efforts of you and the team. So you don't have to do this yourself. And excuse me. If you are watching this right now, it means that you were invited onto this hangout or webinar by Adrian. And you're in a very lucky and privileged position, because as Adrian said at the beginning of this call, he's only really started marketing this in the last couple of weeks and been going with it. So if you are going to take action, do it quickly. Sooner rather than later, because I know Adrian, and Adrian's going to launch this all over in the UK and around the world. And you know, you can benefit from being part of getting a first mover advantage in this lifestyle galaxy Bitcoin mining opportunity. So with that, here's the facts, guys. We're not just a mining company. Lifestyle Galaxy does not just do Bitcoin mining or altcoin mining. We have esports. We run online auctions. We have Galaxy Growth, which is personal development courses, and a whole bunch of other things. We don't do just mining. I'm just speaking to you about the Bitcoin and cryptocurrency mining side right now, because it'll be too much for you to take in one go. But you will discover the other things as we go along. Here's fact number two. We have a growth strategy, which is the repurchase strategy, compounding strategy to grow the mining community, to make sure that we get on the right side of that blockchain pie chart, which will ensure that we are in the top 3 to 5 slices in that pie chart. And we don't just do Bitcoin mining. We do Ethereum, we do Xpans, we do Zcash, we do Litecoin. And we will be introducing coins into the platform, which are quality coins to start mining. We don't just introduce any coins. We only introduce quality coins that have a value. We value our brand. We value what we do, and we stand for quality. So we will only put in quality coins into our mining. And we've given you what we do for you is we give you the ability to purchase the equipment. We maintain everything for you. So we do all of the heavy lifting for you. We do all of the hard work. We do the daily maintenance. All you do is just see how well your Bitcoin mining operation is doing. So with that, guys, I want to say that if somebody offers you an amazing opportunity and you're not sure about it, just say yes, then learn how to do it later. And that's what Richard Branson said. So just like you don't understand everything about electricity, just like you don't understand everything about the internet, you know that when you switch the light on, you get light in the room. You know that when you Google something, you get the information that pops up on your screen. Whether it's right or wrong, that information transfers to you. When you switch on your ignition in your car, you don't know how that engine works, but you know you're able to move from point A to B. In the same way, you are not going to understand every single thing about Bitcoin, Bitcoin mining, or blockchain technology. Just know that you are sitting on the opportunity of a lifetime, which jump in, figure it out, and let's get you going. So thank you for your time. Thank you for watching this. I hope this has served you. I hope you found it insightful. And if you have any questions, please just let me know, or Adrian. And with that, thanks again so much for watching this. And Adrian, I want to hand it over straight back to you. Thank you.
Okay, thanks, Nilesh. Brilliant presentation. Thanks for that, guys. I'm going to unmute everyone. I've got most of my questions answered over the last couple of weeks since getting involved with this. But if you're new to this, you may want to ask some questions live now. That's the whole benefit of this. So let me, you have 35 people on this live Zoom call. And I've got about, just looking on my other screen here, 23 people live on Facebook. So I nearly 70 people, so that's a great turnout. Let me just unmute everyone. If you don't want to speak or ask any questions, guys, then just sort of unmute yourself just to cut out any background noise. I tell you what, let me just look in the chat first just to answer the questions, otherwise we do get quite overwhelmed here. I'm not sure if you want to read these questions as well, Lenilesh. Luvan is asking, why is the registration membership $400 in addition to mining contract? That is, other organizations charge $30 plus each earning contract. What are members receiving for the membership? So basically, Nilesh Luvan is asking, why does somebody have to pay $400? First of all, you don't have to pay $400. Luvan, you can just come in as a free member and just buy a mining contract with $25. So you don't have to pay the $400. That's only for people that want to build a team. So what's your answer to that, Nilesh? Is it more or less the same? Why does somebody have to pay $400?
Yeah. So great question, Mohan. I hope I've got your name right. So the reason for the $400 is for us to become part of the value club and get part of the become a member, we pay the $400 is because what you get as a value club member is access to mining contracts at wholesale prices. So if you look at, as Adrian said, you can start mining without the $400, but you are getting less gigahash for the amount of money that you spend. And the reason for that is because as we go into higher mining contracts, you are able to get more gigahash at a wholesale price. And that just makes it cheaper for our members so that they benefit along the way. And our structure is quite different to other companies. So I can't comment on what other companies are doing. Each company has their own structure and how they lay it out. I would suggest looking into the personal structure of how that company sets it out when you are doing the comparison and, then doing it. However, what I will say is that because you pay the $400 and you're getting the cheaper gigahash, and you compounding, I do know that I do mine with other companies as well. And none of the other companies give the rewards close to what we are getting with the Lifestyle Galaxy. So full disclosure, I do mine with other companies. And the other companies' rewards aren't close to Lifestyle Galaxy. So would I pay the $400 again? Absolutely, because I'm getting more gigahash. I'm getting the ability to compound, which means that over a period of time, which is long-term thinking, I make money faster because compounding makes your money grow a lot quicker. So I hope that answers that for you.
Yeah, that's a great answer. Yeah. And Luvane is asking another question after that, saying to confirm what you said, Nilesh, you're saying, I'm not sure if you can read this the same time as me. Can you get paid down infinite levels? Does it matter whether the link is broken? I'm not sure what he means by that. I do not have to use my downline login to add a new person. They can simply be placed as the next person on the list. I'm not sure where that question is going. Do you have any idea what he means?
Okay, so I got the first part of that, Adrian, which...
Can you see the question in the chat there?
No, I can't actually see the question in the chat.
You can send to me.
Just come to you.
Send to me privately as well. Yeah, hold on.
Yeah.
I've just... hold on. Let me just send this to everyone. Right, just put it in the chat there, Nilesh. Somebody with the link being broken. I'm not sure what he means by that.
Luvan, I'm just gonna. I think the first part of your question, you're asking me to confirm that you can be paid down infinite levels. So I'm gonna assume that you are referring to the CV points or the club points that I spoke about. Yes, those club points or CV points generate from, they go down unlimited levels. So it doesn't matter how many levels, you're not limited to a level 5 or 6 or 7, it goes down unlimited levels down. So you will generate club points or CV points from everyone that comes into your team, regardless of whether you've personally introduced that person or not. I'm not quite sure whether I understand the second part, because I see that you mentioned something about a link that is broken. I do not have to use my downline login to add a new person. They can be simply placed as the next person on the list. Okay, so I'm guessing that you are asking if you manually add a person into the binary. Again, sorry, I'm just guessing, Luvan. When you have two options. You can manually control where the person is placed in your team if you want, or you can set it on automatic. If you like it automatic and you want the system to do it for you, let the system do it for you. With that said, the system will calculate what is best to grow your team. And you know, it's recommended that you leave it for the system to place the person for you, unless you're in a very experienced network marketer who is familiar with manual placements, in which case you can do that as well. So you do have that option to do that. Luvan, I'm not quite sure what's meant by whether the link is broken. So maybe perhaps you could pop us another message with more clarity on that. Hope that answers it.
Yeah, let me know. Luvana, if you want to come live on video and speak, let me know. Some people don't like to come on video and speak, but these messages have been sent to me privately. So perhaps let me know, Luvana, if you want to come on live. I will be unmuting everyone right now, but that's not a problem. Yeah, okay. Just 2 seconds. I'm going to unmute Luvane now. Hi, Luvane.
Hi, it's Luvane.
Luvane, sorry. How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
Who's your sponsor? Am I your sponsor direct or somebody else here on the call?
You. I picked up one of your emails.
All right, great. Like I said, you can always go into a private call or anytime. Anyway, if you have fire away, ask the questions.
Okay, the question was really about the binary, when you talk about the left and the right leg, because I've been in network marketing before, and where it pays down for 8 levels. If you don't actually place one person underneath each person, then you lose out on the payout.
Okay, great question, Luvan. So, so how the binary works is that for you to benefit from the cycling, you need to personally sponsor one person on each side of the binary.
Yeah.
That would enable you to start cycling. And then from there, it doesn't matter how many levels it goes down to, you will always benefit from the CV points coming into the binary. So it can be 8 levels down, it can be 10 levels, it can be 20 levels, 50 levels. It doesn't matter how many levels, it's unlimited. You will always benefit from those points coming up into your binary. The only prerequisite to enable you to start cycling is that you need to have one person on each side of the binary. That's the only prerequisite. Okay. Other than that, the points go unlimited in depth.
Thank you.
And there's also, sorry to interrupt there, there's also a cap, isn't there? $50,000 a week is the most you can earn. Is that right? $50,000 a week is the most you can earn on the cycling?
So what they do, Adrian, with that is that you will earn $50,000. When you get to the point of where you are earning $50,000 per week, what they will do is you are capped at earning the $50,000 on that particular position. But what the company will do is that they will give you another position above that. So okay. You still benefit from everyone beneath it, and you can start adding on the other, instead of adding in that side, you can start adding on the other leg. So although it says capped, you're not really capped to the $50,000.
Okay, great. Yeah, carry on, Luvan.
Okay, and you talked about the earnings and how much you have to pay, and I was wondering if you had an earnings calculator so you can see how much hash power to the dollar you're going to earn, because you talked about cycles.
Okay, so right? So I just want to make sure that I understand this correctly, Luvan. I think, I'm not sure if these are two separate questions or one question.
I don't know, it probably all rolls into one, but you talked about cycles.
Yes.
and so that you're earning hash power, which is equivalent to US dollars.
Yeah, what she means,
if I paid $500 or I paid $1,000, how much hash power would I get per day or per week? How do I check it's actually working?
Yeah, I'm just sharing my screen, Nilesh. I'm not sure if you want to talk her through this. I'm sharing my screen now, Lou. As you can see, I've got 82,000 gigahash here, okay?
Okay.
I started off with, as you can see, 60,000 there and 11,900 bonus. So I started off with 71,930 gigahash, the total of those two there, about 6 weeks ago, I think I started.
Mm-hmm.
Now I've reached 82,000 gigahash, so it's grown, you know, 70 more or less 10,600 gigahash. But if I click on the history here, this box here, it gives me a breakdown of what I've earned on a daily basis since the 20th of September.
Okay.
There's my initial purchase of 60,000 gigahash. I had a bonus of 11,930, but I'm earning, as you can see, I'm earning this gigahash every day because I got it set to 100%. So I'm on around about 315 gigahash a day right now. There's my total running balance. But the question I think you're trying to ask is how do you convert this gigahash back into dollars? Is that right, or BTC?
Yes.
Go on, Nilesh.
So Adrian, if you click on the one next to that, BTC, it'll show you on the top.
Yeah.
If you click on that, BTC, so it'll show you your, go to mining on the top, click on mining, click on purchase mining contract. Okay, and if you scroll down, right, so Luvan, you can see that a $500 package will give you 3,000 gigahash, I'm looking at level one, which is a $500 package.
Yes.
It will give you 3,000 gigahash plus a bonus of 130, which is 3,130 gigahash. Now, we do not use mining calculators for one very specific reason.
Mm-hmm.
Actual mining, when you are actually mining, it's the calculator might give you one figure, but we know that Bitcoin mining is dependent on the difficulty level. So you can't really say with accuracy what figure you are going to get. However, what we do know is that based on our past rewards, like I looked at an account this morning, right now it's well over 13% per month reward that I've been gaining on it. That's an indication of what I've got on that particular account that I saw this morning. And that comes from the compounding. But with the calculators, no, we don't use any calculators because, when you look at what the calculator gives you versus actual mining, and you can do this with other mining companies as well.
Okay.
Look at what you're supposed to get with the calculator versus what you're getting. And it's never going to be 100% accurate because with the actual mining, it's dependent on difficulty level.
Okay.
What I tend to do is, let me go back to my screen here. If I go back into mining, dashboard mining. Have you bought any packages yet, Luvan, or not yet?
No. I just picked up the email. I decided to click on it this evening.
So I click on settings here. I click on settings. I got mine set 100%, okay? So I've set 100% compound or repurchase every day.
Yes.
I'm compounding the full amount. If I decide I want to withdraw tomorrow in cash or Bitcoin,
yes.
I just switch that to 50% or 60% or 35%. So that's if I want to withdraw, you know. But what I tend to work out is, and it's a rough way. If I'm earning 315 gigahash a day,
yes.
To buy that gigahash, if you go onto the Dragon Mining site, $25 gives you 135 gigahash, doesn't it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
If you want to start at the bottom and work up, $25 gives you 135 gigahash, or less. So if I'm earning 315 gigahash a day, I'm not very good at maths, but...
You're multiplying, right?
Exactly. So you can work it out roughly. That works out about probably about $58 a day.
Yes.
So, you know, that's the way I work it out.
Okay.
So,
the wallet and the exchange, is this something I have to do privately?
What, say that again, the exchange.
In terms of having a wallet and exchange, that's not something that your company does. It's something I do privately.
All right, Nilesh, we haven't got, you mean to buy Bitcoins, you mean, or sell Bitcoins, you mean?
Yeah, where you talked about a wallet, you have to put Bitcoins in a wallet.
Yeah, what I recommend is I withdraw all my Bitcoins to blockchain.info, as you can see on my screen here. Am I sharing my screen? Yeah, I'm still sharing my screen. I just put this, I'm going all over the place, you know. If I go into, when I have the 100% settings there, here we go, settings. There you go, my wallet address. So I've got my Bitcoin wallet address in there, okay? That's that. Mm-hmm. So you need to get a Bitcoin wallet address. Have you got a Bitcoin wallet address yet?
Well, I have one, but I haven't used it, if you see what I mean.
Yeah.
Well, because it doesn't do exchange. Apparently, it just stores.
Yeah, at the end of the day, I'm using blockchain, yeah? Let me just 846... I withdraw all my profits or affiliate commissions or compounding into blockchain first.
Yeah.
So I can itemize it. As you can see here, okay, these are, you know, as you can see, I got $98,000 in this account. I know where everything's coming from. I can itemize every transaction. So all these are itemized. So when I start to withdraw from Lifestyle Galaxy, that will be showing you, you know?
Okay.
So all I do is I just click on request. And I create a wallet address. There's my wallet address.
Okay.
Copy and paste that. And I just put that into this box here.
Right.
So I know, so I can withdraw. That's when I want to withdraw. But I don't recommend, I just recommend you accumulate as many Bitcoins as you can. I wouldn't recommend you exchange your Bitcoins and do any other thing, especially dollars or euros or pounds.
Yeah.
If you're starting from fresh, you want to be accumulating Bitcoins, isn't it?
Yes, okay. And
so,
that's blockchain.com, is it?
Blockchain.info.
Yep.
You can start off here as the basic one, the most popular one. You can use, there's other ones then which you can go offline, like exodus.io, and there's a Trezor.
Okay.
And there's other wallets. But I would start off here.
It's made more sense now, thank you.
But basically, just what I say to people is start with $25, dip your toe in, spend $25, spend $50 or $100. Mm-hmm. Buy one of these packages, set up your Bitcoin wallet, set it to 100% compound, daily compound, perhaps set it to 50% compound for 1 or 2 days, and then see how it all works, do a withdrawal, test it, and then you can start scaling up from here and decide if you want to become, if you want to join the value club, then an upgrade to the $400 payment. That's up to you then at a later point. But I bring all my people in on the $25 package first just to start things off.
Right. Okay.
Yeah.
Luan, it's also dependent on the amount that you want to start with. If you want to start with $500 or more, then maybe it's best to go in straight into the value club because you're going to get access to mining contracts at wholesale prices, which over a period of time is where it is far more profitable.
Yes.
So that would be my other suggestion as well. Even if you're not going to network it, that's fine. Yes. But take advantage of the wholesale prices. Because the compounding effect, 6 months, 12 months down the line is huge. Adrian, I can show you a quicker way of doing the calculation instead of going to Dragon Mining. So if you go to mining and you go to your dashboard where you are right now, go to your dashboard for BTC.
Yeah.
Scroll all the way down. So yeah, you can see your 24-hour summary. Oh, is it not giving you the dollar value?
No, Nilesh, what's actually happened is I've been on to Mariska about this many, many a times, and Andrew, and they've taken away the dollar value and the BTC value. So what was actually happening on this screen here where I was just showing you on this history settings here?
Yeah.
We did have the gigahash, we got the gigahash value, but we
yeah,
did have the BTC and the dollar taken away.
It has the dollar value, and the Bitcoin value. So I'm not sure why that's not showing on yours.
Well, it's showing on you're telling me it's showing on yours, not mine.
It should be showing because I know other people's are showing. I'm not.
No, they've taken it away in the last couple of weeks. In the last week or so, they've taken it away. Everybody's the same.
No. It did come back. It came back.
Okay, we'll bring a few other people in on the call then. But why hasn't mine come back then?
It's supposed to be back. It's back. It is back. I know that for sure. Maybe you just need to pop support a message to ask them. Or what I'll do is I'll just...
If you want to put a question, if anyone's if anyone's BTC or dollar amount has come back, if you put a question in the chat, guys, that'll be great. That'd be great to hear that I am got it. And
Matt, can you just confirm with us if yours is visible, Matt?
I'm going to unmute everyone. Just 2 seconds.
No, not at all. I've looked at mine today, and it's not there. Yeah. I even cleared my cookies out on my computer, and it's just not there. Yeah. So probably an issue there. I was watching a video today, and I actually saw the dollar things on his YouTube video. And I said, "Hang on a minute, mine's completely different." Yeah. So I actually cleaned my cookies. It's just not there. So I think there's probably an issue with the site.
Okay, what I'm going to do is it seems like maybe it might be just happening to the UK side. So what I'm going to do is, Adrian, I'll pop a message in our group there just to let them know that we did
that. Okay, I'll do that.
Because I do know that in South Africa...
It's a bit annoying. I can't work out.
Peter, can you mute your microphone, please? Peter PC.
All right.
This guy's having a private conversation here between us all. Hold on. Let me just get rid of Peter. Hold on. Peter, please, can you remove yourself or mute yourself rather, just to let me just mute Peter.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys. Carry on. I was distracted then.
Yeah.
Hi, Nilesh.
Hi there.
Hi, quick question. I had this question as well myself, first webinar. I got some prospects asking me what are the benefits of going into the mining as retail and the main difference of going into the mine as a wholesale, as in purchasing the club, as in the difference and the options with networking or non-networking. Because a concern I had in the beginning was that obviously I didn't want to go ahead and recommend the mining myself until I get retailing and see some difference myself.
Okay. Great question, Conrad. So the difference between the Value Club and Dragon Mining is obviously number one, in that Value Club you're paying $400. Versus Dragon Mining, you're not paying the $400. However, as Lugan asked Alion, what do you get for the $400? So, what do you actually get for the $400 on the mining side is that if you're going to go in for a contract that's worth $500 or more, I would personally go into the Value Club. And the reason for that is because in the Value Club, you're getting gigahash at wholesale prices. So what do I mean by that? What do I mean wholesale prices? It means that you're getting more gigahash. So because you're getting more gigahash, let's look at the daily compounding. The daily compounding effects of more gigahash are $500 on Dragon Mining versus $500 on the being a Value Club member. Is that over a period of, say, a couple months down the line, I don't know, maybe 6 months down the line, but definitely 12 months down the line, the amount of Bitcoin you are producing is significantly better on the Value Club. And the reason for that is because you're starting with, it might look minutely little bit more of gigahash that you're beginning with. But we must always remember that because Lifestyle Galaxy has the daily compounding effect, compounding over a period of time adds up to a lot more. It's like going, you know, 1 + 1 = 2, you know, and we add another 1 is going to be 3. Add another 1 is going to be 4. Add another 1 is going to be 5. But if we look at exponential growth, you know, 1 + 1 = 2.
Two is 4.
4 + 4 = 8. You know, we're growing exponentially.
2 lengths of a path.
And over a period of time,
45 seconds
versus the dragon mining. So you're getting more gigahash. And as, let's say, someone who goes in now, if you're putting $2,500, someone who wants to buy even a $5,000 mining contract, if you take the $5,000 and you look at the amount of gigahash you're getting on dragon mining versus the $5,000 gigahash that you're getting on a Lifestyle Galaxy as a Value Club member, you're getting significantly more, and that more than covers up the $400 that you're going to that you're paying up front. So we must always think long term. We must think and we must think like entrepreneurs, in the sense that what are we going to get later on? Sometimes short term rewards isn't the best, because we might get a short term, but we lose out later on.
Right, I'm sorry guys, let me just mute everyone because there's people all background noise. So yeah, carry on. I've lost track of who was speaking then because of the background noise. Conrad, really? Yeah. Conrad, yeah.
Yeah, Conrad, did that. I've had some of the people over here asking me the same kind of question that I had, and it's...
Oh, sorry, Conrad, I didn't get that. There was just some background noise that came in.
That's fine. No, it's because the first time when you're seeing the difference in $25 and the wholesale, but you've just explained it very, very well. So I hope it explains it for the rest of us.
Perfect. Yeah. So just let me just explain that again. So if you're going to go, let's say like $5,000, right? With $5,000, you're going to get a lot more gigahash versus buying 10 times 500 on the Dragon Mining side. Because the maximum you can buy on Dragon Mining starts at 25, goes up to 500, right? You can't buy $1,000 or $2,000 or $5,000, $10,000 on Dragon Mining. You cannot buy higher than $500. When you buy on Galaxy Mining, Lifestyle Galaxy, you start at $500 and you can go up as high as you want. Now, Galaxy Mining gives us more gigahash per our dollar value that we purchase for. So that means that over a period of time, if we take $5,000, we have the option of paying 10 times $500 in Dragon Mine to save $400. Or we can take the $5,000 and push it into Lifestyle Galaxy, which will give us more gigahash and compounding in a couple of months. And definitely further down the line, it adds up to better rewards, far better rewards than being on Dragon Mine, purely because we start with more gigahash, we're compounding faster. So the example I said right now is that if we go 1 + 1 = 2, add another 1 = 3, add another 1 = 4, add another 1 = 5. So at 5 levels, we are number 5. But if I start with 2 times 2 = 4. Yeah, we go 4 times 2 = 8. 8 double is 16. 16 double is 32. 32 double is 64. So that's compounding over a period of time. It grows quicker versus just not doing the compounding. And you're able to compound in both. But if someone has the ability to go into Galaxy Mining, even if you don't want to do the networking, you are still benefiting from wholesale prices of gigahash.
Yeah,
you're still making up the $400 that you pay.
Fantastic. Perfect explanation.
Great. Yeah. That helps. Great, Conrad. Thanks. Yeah. Great question.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Anyone got any more questions?
I just asked one last question.
Yeah, one. Luvan, yeah.
How long do the contracts last?
Great question, Luvan. So whilst we say the contract is actually 3 years, it is not 3 years. In net effect, the contract is actually a lifetime value contract. Why is that so? The reason it is a lifetime contract, the real effect is that it is a lifetime contract, is because when you start mining, you are purchasing gigahash every single day. Every day, someone who comes into mining is always going to purchase at least 35% more gigahash on their compounding. So that means that their compounding always takes them up to more gigahash. So the short answer to your question is that it is a lifetime contract. Without it is not a limited contract.
Thank you.
Great.
Any more questions? Matt, have you got any questions?
No, but I think I've sussed out the website, really. If you go to your history.
Right, hold on, let me share my screen.
Yeah, if you open the screen up. Yeah, if you go to your history, this is only UK, mind you.
Yeah.
And if you go to, it says Bitcoin Standard Gigahash, and then the one, there's a button next door to it, it says BTC. Yeah?
Where are you? Can you see my screen?
Yeah, go to history.
Yeah.
Oh, completely different to my one. Aha, right. Go to the BTC, not the Bitcoin. That's it, yeah. Click there. Oh, yours is empty. Yes. Okay. Well, mine's full. But, it's probably, I think it must be an issue in the websites, really.
I think it's an upgrade on the site, because it's supposed to show on the,
I even cleaned my cookies out on my computer an hour ago, and I thought it might be stuck cookies.
How much information is on your page, Matt? Going back the history of how far?
The same. It's just like they've is that the same as yours now? They've changed it again.
So yeah. It's probably just because of the update, guys. So what I'm going to do I'm going to pop Adrian in our group. I'm going to pop Mariska and Doc Ant a message.
History is empty. Yeah. That's it. Yeah, so is mine.
They need to get that fixed. They've been dragging on with this.
Yeah, because I get people asking me all the time saying, how much were a day? I haven't seen my figures. What's my price?
And you know what? We didn't actually know because we've seen it, like the guys in South Africa and everywhere else have been seeing it normal. So we didn't actually know. I think that the UK one is. Obviously, this has just been some snag, which I'm sure they'll be able to resolve. So I'm going to pop a message, and we can get it sorted as soon as possible.
So I always get people always ask me, how much
do I spend? $25
or $100, and you've got to, I've got to go to like Alucom and try and work it out myself, and it's hard work,
No, it shouldn't be like that.
What I would do, Matt, if you're struggling with that, is just do what I said earlier. Get
like. That's what I've been doing. Just use the figures.
I earned 315 gigahash today.
Yeah.
I divide that by 135, isn't it?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Just gives a basis, really. But you can't go, at the end of the day, you've got to use your,
$58 a day.
Yeah,
so I just worked out roughly myself, $58 a day, but just by cutting myself.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, but if I can fix that website, that'd be that save us so much time.
Really I don't think they are aware that you guys can't see it in the UK.
Yeah.
So, because I know everywhere else has been fine. So I will pop in a message as soon as we jump off the score, and then we'll.
I'm glad we solved it though, because that could have been an issue, That's very good.
Yeah, no, that's very, very frustrating and irritating. So, I'm just surprised you guys have been so patient for so long.
Oh, well, we're British, you see.
Good stuff. Yeah. Okay, guys.
Adrian, have you checked whether Singapore is on the list?
Sorry, say again?
You were telling me on the ban list. Is Singapore on the ban list?
No, Singapore is fine, isn't it, Nilesh? Singapore, Malaysia, those countries are fine, aren't they?
Malaysia is fine. I don't know where about Singapore is.
You don't know where Singapore is?
I don't know where they are on the list. Put it that way.
No, James, I'll talk to you after the call. You are fine because you have, there's no block on your IP address. It's fine.
Yeah. Okay. Have you checked out my thing?
Yeah, you've been positioned, James. It's all fine. I've done it. You're positioned.
All right. Right. Really good. Really good.
Yeah, I done it about half an hour ago.
Yeah, I have to. I chose the. I think the other one. You know, so I need to pay for 3 months. The reason I did that was because I wanted some money to buy the mining packages.
Right. Yeah, what James is saying, instead of paying his upgrade to the value club in one payment, he split it over 3 payments, haven't he? Is that right?
Yeah, that's correct.
Yeah. Yeah, which is an easier way to pay, really, if you're on a budget or you want to hold your money back to use for mining packages instead. So, yeah, so it's a good way of doing it, really. Yeah. So.
Yeah.
Great. Great to see you and hear from you again, James.
Good. What I'm going to ask you now is, I'm going to get my wife into this. All right. Now, is there any problem using the same IP?
No.
Okay.
No problem.
But what she needs is a different email address, right?
Yeah, it's got to be a different email address. But the IP is fine.
Okay, good. I'm going to get it in then.
Yeah, no problems with IP. That's good news. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to get more Bitcoin packages. I'm going to upgrade a bit more. Let's see how it goes.
Yeah. You may be worth, if you're going to sponsor your wife, James, you may,
yeah,
may be worth buying the Bitcoin mining packages underneath your wife's account.
Yeah.
Okay. You know
what
I mean?
Yeah.
Because you'll get some extra points. And is that right, Nudesh? You get some extra points and commissions at some point.
Sorry, if he's going, I didn't quite grab that.
James is going to sponsor his wife and he's going to buy more mining packages. He's better off putting them under his wife's account.
Yes,
obviously that would benefit him in the longer term.
Yeah, if he's going to sponsor his wife, he should put his mining contracts in his wife's account and not his account.
Yeah.
So he can benefit from the CV that's in there.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Yeah, that would be better.
Yeah, right.
That's it. Great stuff. Any more questions from anyone?
Yes, please.
Oh, Prakash, yeah, fire away, mate. Fire away. Go on.
Does this business work in all the countries around the world, or is it?
No.
Is it some countries it doesn't work in?
It doesn't work in India, Bangladesh, or Pakistan to start with, and there's a lot of other countries as well, isn't it?
So, great question, Prakash. We are not open in all countries around the world, and the reason for that is because whenever we go into any country, we've got to comply with the laws and regulations that are in there. So, every single country that we are currently open in, we are fully compliant with all laws and all regulations of that country. If we are not open in a specific country as yet, it is because of one of two reasons. Number one is, for us to open up a country, we need to make sure that we have leadership in that country. So it's not just about opening up IPs and allowing people to register on the site. We need to ensure that we have leadership in the country that will run the company for us there. When I say run, I mean, you know, grow it there. Number two is that we need to make sure that we are compliant with the laws and regulations of that country, because different countries have different laws. So we need to make sure we are compliant with all of that. So when we are open in any country, we are fully compliant with that. We not only seek legal advice before we open those countries, but we ensure that everything is above board. So we do seek legal advice before we open up a country to make sure everything that we do is above board. And that's because we are going to be here for the long term. We're not in this for the short term to ensure that, you know, to make a quick buck overnight. We're here to, this company's been around for 10 years next year. And we're going to be here for the next 10, the next 15, the next 20. So that's how we do things to protect our members, to make sure that this is going to be here for them, not just a year, not just 2 years, but 10 years, 20 years, 30 years down the line.
Okay.
So that's the reason for that. It's important to understand why we do that.
Sure. Is there a list in the website stating which countries?
Yes, there is a list.
It's in the group. It's in the group. It's in the group, Prakash. It's in our group. Okay. It's in the Facebook group. Yeah.
Okay. Another quick question. There's another company where mining contracts are limited. Is there any chance of this ever happening to this company where there'll be a shortage of mining contracts?
So great question, Prakash, as well. I do know some of the other companies out there have been limited for at least a month. Exactly. And the reason why, at least a month, if not longer, the reason why we haven't been limited is because we've put certain agreements into place with some of the suppliers to ensure that we get certain deliveries by specified dates. And obviously on the corporate end, they anticipate a certain amount of demand and they pre-order months in advance. So there's a lot of planning that goes onto this in the back end of it, because obviously this is a real business. So we look at they need to look at the growth of the company, what's happening, the pre-order status that needs to be put in before that. And we've been successful in the way we plan ourselves in anticipating growth and what we're capable of doing, as well as having good relationships with suppliers where we've been able to meet the demands of our customers.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Pleasure.
Yeah. Any more questions, guys?
When are you going to come on again, Neil Asher?
So, James, what we've, between Adrian and myself, what we've decided to do is we will be doing this webinar presentation and live Q&A every Tuesday, probably at 8 p.m. UK time. And I'll just come on, I'll do the live webinar presentation, we'll do a Q&A, and we'll also bring in some special guests like Andrew Eaton, like Tony De Guevara, as time goes by. And as we grow this. To answer your question, every Tuesday at 8 p.m. UK time. However, there are the exceptions like today where we're doing it on a Wednesday. And, we might relook at the time and day as and when we move forward. So, right. Yeah. So you're seeing it on a weekly basis.
No, that's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, great.
Oh, if anyone else needs to reach out to me as well, please, I am on Facebook. You can reach out to me on Facebook. If you Adrian or myself, just pop us a message. And just by the way, if you don't get hold of me, please do know that I do reply. It's just that there's a time difference between the USA where I am right now and I might be in conferences or certain things. So if there's a delay in reply, please know that I'm not ignoring you. I'm not messaging you. That I will get back to you if it does take a bit longer, but I do always respond to every single message. Okay.
Yeah, we're all pretty active on Facebook. We got our own little group going, so we're all pretty active. Most of us are pretty full time on this now. Myself and Matt Feast and a few others, we work in this full time. So yeah, we're always about for Q&A questions. But what are you suggesting, Nilesh? We can do this as we do this every week now, isn't it? Like an up. A weekly update for new people as well. Just keep it going every week, isn't it? Consistent.
Yeah. Let's do this every week. We can do a presentation. Obviously, the presentation will get shorter as we go by. And we can do a Q&A as well. And obviously, our goal is to expand in the UK and for you to be the leader there and with your team there. So let's do this where we are going to be there every week. We are providing a presentation as well as a support structure, and we can assist the team to grow their teams as well, because, it's about helping them. And in 6 to 12 months, everyone on here that chooses to do strategy 2, which is grow a team, will be earning a significant amount of increased income. That's what we're here to help to do.
Okay, brilliant. Does anyone see? How are you, Carl Everett? Do you have any questions? How are you doing?
No, I'm fine, thanks.
Oh, brilliant. Okay, great to see you. That's great. What about you, David Cardozone? You have any questions?
No, I'm good, apart from that situation with opening that Dragon Mine and Galaxy Lifestyle separately. I still haven't sorted that out. I need to contact support on that.
Sorry, David, what's the issue that you're having there?
The issue is I joined Dragon Mine.
Yes.
And I wanted to join the value-added club on Dragon Mine, and it wouldn't allow me. So I went over to Galaxy Lifestyle and opened an account with Galaxy Lifestyle. So now I've got two separate accounts.
Okay. Okay, I see. Did you in Dragon Mining? Do you have a mining contract in there?
Yes. I've got two 500 mining packages in Dragon Mine, and a 500-pound contract in Lifestyle Galaxy.
Okay, so it wasn't allowing you to upgrade. Okay, maybe just pop support a message. Let's see what they can do. If they can perhaps just link it all into one.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks for that.
Pleasure.
Okay, everyone, we've been going for about 2 hours, 20 minutes, so that's more than enough, I think. Unless anyone's got any more questions, we can call it a night, I think.
Yeah, the Swiss goal, have you spoken to Matt about that?
Well, we can't talk about that now. James, that's a separate company. I want to keep this call to just okay. To Galaxy Mining, yeah. Lifestyle Galaxy. We have to talk about that after this call if you want.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so any more questions, guys? Otherwise, I'll call you a night. There's nothing in the chat. I haven't really been checking the Facebook Live. I've forgotten about Facebook Live. We're on there as well. So I'm not sure there's any questions coming on Facebook Live. But if so, I'll try and deal with them later. But okay, you can call it a night, guys. Thanks, Nilesh, again. This is the second one. This has been recorded. I'll try and get this uploaded to my YouTube channel, where people can copy and extract it and send, create their own and send it out to their team.
Yeah.
So that's the best way. A lot of people don't get onto the call. They may want to watch the recording,
Yeah. Pleasure. It's only been a pleasure. And thanks everyone for being here. Thanks for staying on the song and for watching, and hope that helps.
Yeah. Okay, then, guys. Have a night.
Cheers, everyone.
Bye. Prakash, all you guys.
Thanks,
mate. Oh, David, all the best. Cheers, everyone.
Bye, Eddie.
Bye, bye. All the best.
Bye.
Bye, buddy.